Up front next, breaking news. The man who jumped the White House fence had more than 800 rounds of ammo in his car. How did he get through the front door of the White House? And more breaking news, a new message from ISIS tonight calling for lone wolves to kill civilians in America, as officials are warned that Americans fighting militants overseas are now back on U.S. soil. Plus, the FBI joining the hunt for a missing UVA student. How did police let the person last seen with Hannah Graham get away? Let's go out front. And out front now, Congressman Mike Turner, Republican from... Sir, you just heard Jim Sciutto reporting Americans trained with terror groups are now returning to the United States. How big of a threat is this?
It's a direct threat. And that's...
Which are the two countries that have been leading the airstrikes, which is why you're going to get that. The question, though, remains that of capability. Intent is one thing. Capability is another. I mean, in a sense, this sounds a bit adolescent. When you hear what they're saying, obviously their intent would be is far from that, but it doesn't necessarily read that they have it all together.
But you know, clearly they have a significant capability, having come out of Syria, taking a good portion of the territory.
How many Americans do you think that there could be? I know they're now saying a few, but obviously 100 or so at least went over to fight. So do you think the number could end up significantly higher? Or?
Absolutely. Well, that's the other thing that's
the other breaking story tonight. Jim Acosta reporting on the man who jumped the White House fence. You see that video running all the way up to the White House door, which was unlocked, getting in. I mean, are the Secret Service to blame here? I mean, it sounds like that's who dropped the ball specifically.
Well, clearly, since we know that protocols...
Just a stunning, absolute stunning breach. Thank you so much. Appreciate your time, Congressman.
Thank you.
And on Wednesday, I'm going to be interviewing former President Bill Clinton. We're going to ask him about the threat from ISIS. And you'll... Tonight, the Baltimore Ravens insist there was no cover-up of the Ray Rice domestic assault case. The team's owner, Steve Bisciotti, insisting ESPN's damning report that the team knew about the videotape of Ray Rice knocking out his now wife. By the way, in excruciating detail, walked through scene by scene everything that happened in hours after the attack. Well, Bisciotti says it's all lies. There was, though, something else that caught on with that couple right now. Well, former NFL player Don McPherson is with me. I did not know, Don, that they named their daughter after the Ravens. And that little detail, for some reason, seems to be rather poignant, giving a sense at what they're going through right now. What do you make of it?
I think one of the problems for...
You know, you've been very open about this, that a college boyfriend knocked you probably in awe of that, because they haven't been able to do that. You hear Janae's friends talking about her and Ray, and what do you hear?
I hear, Rice, you have to quit talking about this. You have to quit appearing in public with Elevator.
Right, and the guilt she still feels, because you're saying when you went through it, some of your friends were defending...
Right.
The boyfriend.
But
defending
I completely
why you should,
understand it from her standpoint. She didn't, but that's how she feels.
The owner of the Ravens, who is saying that a zero-tolerance policy would create an environment of false accusations and ruin players' careers.
Right.
I mean, that is a stunningly...
It's the slippery slope towards accountability,
isn't it?
Insensitive.
Right. I'm appalled that even when someone would counsel him to go out, that he would say it.
Right. Well, that's the problem clearly no one counseled him, because he didn't even employment in the National Football League.
Yeah.
That's where the zero tolerance
is. But they won't, because he's a great player. The thing that struck me during that whole news conference, but he wasn't curious enough to actually want to watch the tape of what happened in that elevator, because he didn't close your eyes to their faults. Because that's not really, but he would not let him play football again. I just find that strange.
And it's strange because he doesn't have the
answer. About the people would do this, when someone would accuse him of violence to get money. I mean, what money?
Well,
what I don't understand.
To extort players.
Okay, but if they're going to lose their job and not be paid anymore, then there goes the money. So I kind of lose the logic there.
See, I took it, and it might be because, you know,
that kind of money. Yeah.
Right.
But I don't know.
Here's the problem for this conversation now, and the press conferences like this afternoon. Control the narrative.
Yep.
When do we ask?
To both of you. And out front next, Sierra Leone discovered more than 90 bodies this weekend, all of them victims of Ebola. The spread is now getting close to exponential. We're going to go live to Liberia. Plus, iPhone mania. Just how many new iPhones has Apple sold in 3 days? And adios, Anchorage. Jeannie Mose on a fine art of signing off. Phones. Anderson starts now.
Your effort ever did, but Sterling's wife, this was so interesting, she's suing Stiviano, saying he had no right and you don't get to keep it, so she wants it all back.
Wow. All right, thank you very much to Deb.